The WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Brock Lesnar puts the title on the line against Roman Reigns. I think it was obvious, even during the Shield days, that Roman was going to be the next top guy. You had his team at Survivor Series that one year, like, looked like they were going to get blown out until it was only him left, and then he fucking eliminated everybody else. Then you had the Royal Rumble. He broke Kane's record, for Christ's sake. He broke Kane's record. And then, what else? I mean, I can't really think of anything else during a Shield run. But then, immediately after he got out of the Shield, he's in the World Championship match at Money in the Bank. He's in another one at Battleground. He's in these high-profile matches, and then he gets hurt. He gets hurt. He comes back in December, announces his spot on the Royal Rumble, and he wins the Royal Rumble. Now, I didn't think that Rumble was as predictable as last year. I mean, because you thought about it wasn't as predictable up until the end. You had Kane and Big Show, along with Reigns and Ambrose still left. And I still had some hope for the Lunatic Fringe, but then they tossed him out the same way they tossed out Wyatt, the same way they tossed out Ziggler. And I think right when they tossed out Dean Ambrose, the crowd fucking booed the shit out of everything, because then it was so obvious that Reigns is gonna win. Because look at Kane and the Big Show. For the past few weeks before the Rumble, even month before the Royal Rumble, hell, even months, these guys are not even months, but like maybe the past few weeks before the Rumble, even the past full 1 month before the Rumble. These guys are coming off as these jobbers, Kane and Big Show are coming off as jobbers, then all of a sudden in the Rumble, they're these dominant motherfuckers that they once were during their prime. Oh man. I don't know. Not really a big fan of the Big Show. I've always had tons of respect for him, and I will admit that he's always been pretty athletic. I met him though. It was worth meeting him. He's a cool guy, but I don't know. I was just never really too big on him. But Kane, I'll admit, I was always a big Kane fan. Not of this corporate thing really, but the big red monster and all that, And I think Kane should have. I think Kane deserved way better in a world championship spot. Yeah, at this point, I don't think Kane should like win that kind of shit. But I don't know. I mean, even though I don't really, I'm not a fan of corporate Kane. I've always had tons of respect for him, man. He's definitely one of my all-time faves. But let's get back on track. So Reigns wins the Rumble, and then he's gonna, and he has to defend his shot against Daniel Bryan at Fastlane. So I was thinking if Daniel Bryan was gonna be in the main event, then it should be a triple threat. Because I mean, no matter what, I think whoever wins the Royal Rumble should be in the main event of WrestleMania. Because other than that, it just kind of like doesn't give the Rumble any prestige. But yeah, I mean, I'm glad that at least Reigns is in it. But I don't know, this buildup is falling flat. I mean, when Reigns won at Fastlane, I was like, all right, they've got 35 days, they've got 7 weeks until WrestleMania to get me interested in this, to really build things up and bring more interest. But they've hardly even done that. Let's see. Did they have Brock Lesnar there the night after Fastlane? I can't fucking remember, man. My timeline is off. And then they didn't have him the week after, at least I don't think they did. Fuck, I can't even remember. They had him this past week. Heyman cut a godlike promo. This guy's amazing. But yeah, I don't know, man. I mean, And I'm pretty sure Brock Lesnar is gonna leave though, because Heyman referenced the Montreal Screwjob when he said, you know, if anybody dares pull a Montreal Screwjob on Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania, I can guarantee that that person won't leave there alive. And, you know, the Montreal Screwjob, Brett was planning to leave WWF to go to WCW. So, you know, maybe that's the reference there, that Brock Lesnar is already planning to leave WWE to go back to UFC. But, yeah, this buildup is falling flat, man. And, I don't know. I've seen some improvement with Reigns, especially with his moveset. He did the dead man dive that one time on Raw, the dead man dive. And, I mean, it didn't look like the best. It wasn't the best one. It was nowhere near how The Undertaker does it. But, I mean, just to be able to get himself over that top rope was amazing. I'll give him that. But I don't know, man. 2 weeks left. 2 weeks. I don't know if they're gonna. If they're gonna build this better, they better do it fucking quickly. And as for fucking SmackDowns, I hardly ever watch SmackDown anymore. Honestly, the last few times I watched SmackDown were the ones that I've went to. But I don't know. I heard Brock Lesnar was supposed to make an appearance on SmackDown. I'm not too sure, but yeah, I don't know. But yeah, we'll. I doubt it, but we'll see if they gain any more interest for this match, for the fans. I don't know, man. I just don't know.